Welcome to the Hero Show.
B.
E.
N.
C.
H.
Did you get it?
A.
R.
Hey!
Of course, next week is benchmark, so we want to help you get in
benchmark mode.
So check this out.
The benchmark has been around a very, very long time. But many a school child has wondered, where did it come from? Well, kids, the answer is, we're not exactly sure. But this is what we do know. Some of the first people to take the benchmark were cavemen. Of course, they weren't tested over the same things as today. Instead, they were measured on stuff like fire starting, berry gathering, and of course, atlatl throwing. Some were proficient, some were not. Later, the benchmark made its way to ancient Egypt. They used the math that they learned while preparing for the benchmark to build the Great Pyramids. In 1492, Columbus sailed the ocean blue. Not only did he discover what would become America, he also brought the benchmark to the New World. Thanks, Christopher. When the Constitution was signed in 1787, the benchmark became the law of the land. Without the writing skills they learned getting ready for the test, our founding fathers would never have written such a perfect document. As the United States grew, the benchmark grew too. Be advanced, young man. Be advanced. Later, with its emphasis on math and science, the benchmark made the Industrial Revolution possible, which led to planes, trains, and automobiles. Without the benchmark, we would never have landed on the moon, invented television and computers, or created cell phones. Who says the benchmark isn't important? And now the benchmark has made its way through history to you. The question is, are you ready?
Smart.
Huh?
Pencil.
Rocks.
Rewards.
Lunch.
Boring.
Test.
Beaches.
Have fun.
Prep.
Domination.
Paper.
Awesome.
Going to Disney World!
Have a party.
Celebrate for doing my best.
Go outside and run and scream.
Eat pizza.
Really? I'm running 188 miles from Houston to Austin.
I'm gonna celebrate. Oh, I'm gonna celebrate.
Read books.
Drink milk.
Go shopping.
Calling my mom.
Go to Disneyland.
Eat peaches.
Congratulate myself.
Reading.
Essays.
Math.
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 Mathematics.
Snack time.
Writing.
Writing.
English. English.
Reading.
You fill in the bubbles with your name.
Reedy.
If we had to.
The answers.
Mechanical pencil. Answer key.
Electronic device.
My phone.
Google.
Fine. Mr. Donnell.
Helicopter.
Coffee and chocolate.
My iPod. Raise the roof.
Yeah.
Most definitely.
Eh.
Totally.
I doubt it.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I hope so.
It depends on the fifth grader.
Duh.
Yeah.
Probably.
Yup.
I agree.
No! No would be the answer!
Try your best!
Eat tacos and enjoy it.
Focus and try your hardest.
Write a full page and a half on the essay.
I don't know.
Go to the bathroom before.
Do your best and don't give up.
Sleep.
No cheating.
Do your best.
Try.
I can't think. I can be it like 5 seconds. Hold on.
Anxiety.
Eat peaches before coming to school.
Focus.
The answer's right.
Do your best on the test.
Thanks for watching.